But he that doeth the will of the Most High abideth forever.
It is. Mm-hmm. Don't we want to abide forever? Don't we want to live forever? Yeah. Hey, even in Cooley, I'm sorry, in Cooley High, there was a scene in Cooley High, the movie, Glenn Turman, he's talking to, what's his name, Eric Morris. And he said, son, Eric Morris said, son, what is it you want? And he said, I want to live forever. Garrett Moore backed away from in the movie Cooley High. Yeah. He didn't have the answer.
Right.
Now, what's the answer to living forever?
His words.
Words.
His words. That's beautiful, because that's exactly what I thought of when you read that scripture. The brother read the scripture. It's like, if you read it again, the last part, Baruch Hashem.
First John 2 and 17. And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof, but he that doeth the will of the Most High abideth forever.
He abideth forever, because the more faith that you have, you know, the more that you show yourself diligent to the truth, guess what? The Lord is going to feed you more. And then when the more and more diligent you have, then the Lord feeds you, then you're able to feed others more. But what happens is guys just run out of steam because they just gave up the will of the Lord. You know, they gave up. They said, I'm not doing this anymore. So the Lord ain't giving them nothing, you know, not feeding them. Therefore, you can't feed others, man.
Yeah, what the scripture say that I had a sincere milk of the word that you may grow thereby. You know, abounding in the word, not being slothful in the word.
It was supposed to continually grow. There is no point where I'm fully grown. I don't need to. No. We're always growing. I've been in this thing many years. I still feel, man, I'm really growing.
That's the spirit, man.
You know, and I've been in this thing for a while. All right, so there's never a point you come to, yeah, I know where I'm.
Yes.
Yeah. No, we're always growing. Yeah. Living water never stops.
That's right.
Living water keeps flowing, and you've got to flow with it. That's right. Yeah. Or else it leaves you behind.
That's right.
And this is living water.
You had guys back then that thought that. They thought after they learned what they had to learn, that was it.
Well, Mafia, he made that statement.
Why
we can't just stay with what we got? That's why he grew old and curled up and died.
There's a joke coming out of Psalm 23. Can Shalom, all praises, honor, and glory due to Yahweh, Bashem Yahweh Shai. The true name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, and His Son's name is Yahweh Shai, who the world ignorantly called God and Jesus. Alright? Double honors to the apostles and elders at GMS, you know, the brothers in the four corners of the earth. You know, they push this word in sincerity and in truth. You know, much love and respect. You know, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, Bashem Bahara Kakodash to you brothers, you know. This is a testimony that I want to do on taking heed lest thou fall. Let me just take off this. Alright, yeah, taking heed, lest thou fall. You know, my name is Gorasham, you know, from GMS Guyana. What you just see is Apostle Gabar, you know, and the other Apostle, Apostle Ariamla, and the elder brothers. You know, they point to the spirit that jump on brothers. And that spirit is brothers feel that they have enough and lay back. And feel like, hey, I learned enough and you know, I could stick for this. You know, that's because you don't want to go through that straight gate. Alright? And let me see, about three months ago, you know, about approximately three to 4 months ago, that spirit jumped on me. You know, I was catching a lot of hell, you know, to the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. The Most High was putting a fire on me, you know, and I was catching so much hell, and I kept going and I kept going and I kept going. You know, but Like I said, I was kept going. I was literally feeling like I was losing breath. You know, because the demons then were so much messing around me, you know, and one thing I was lacking was I wasn't fasting because my life was so hectic. You know, out of work, then you get the truth, then your woman, and then your kid, you know, and you know, and then the demons, you know, they right there. You know, and that demon jumped on me, you know. I held back, and that demon jumped on me. And after that, I went to sleep. I went to sleep. One night I was sleeping, and whilst I was sleeping, between sleep and wake, you know, I see the angel that is be, you know, there's an angel that is be by every brother. Because when I now come in this truth, the elder brother, you know, your brothers may know him, that taught me this truth, which is Bukhar, you know. You know, Shalom elder. He taught me this truth, and when I now come into this truth, you know, before everything, I pray and ask the Lord. At that time I didn't know his name, and I know for a fact that his name wasn't Jesus, all right? And I didn't believe in Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai yet. And what had happened is I was in the shower and I prayed and I said, Lord, if it's this what you want me to be, this is what you want me to do, because I asked you to lead me to the kingdom, because I don't know the truth. I'm looking for the truth. I'm tired. I'm weary. You know. And you know what the Lord did? When I went to sleep that night, a tall, like about 8 foot, 9 foot, you know, angel come at my door. And the brother, the elder, he was the one, you know, he was like, he had the Bible in his hand and he was sending the fire. He was like, get him, you know, and he was blazing the word. And the angel come by my door. And when the angel come at my door now, and when the angel come at my door, my spirit was troubled because I feel the dread of the angel. And I start to cry, you know, because I thought the angel coming to kill me. You know, and this angel, tall, about 9 foot, I couldn't see the face, and I couldn't see the hands, but what I could have seen is a linen garment down to the foot, and the size of this man's chest was so broad, you know, because when the angel come at my door, keep in mind this is a vision, you know. And I run to this angel, and I jump and hug this angel, expecting this angel to pull out a sword and shove in my side because of the wicked shit that I used to do. I expect the Lord, the angel, to put me to death. And all I know was an angel, and wasn't in the scriptures. I don't know. You know, but before that, you know, when as I go by in this truth, I understand that it was an angel, you know, and that's one of the things that keep me going. Alright? So that angel that come by my side since that night, and I never look back, but you know, when Shalakia brothers, you know, I'm trying to get as clear as possible, you know, for brothers, you know, younger brothers, you know, and the elders, and the apostles, you know. Yahabashim Yahushai, I hope you all brothers, you know. I'm trying to make it concise as possible so you brothers could understand and it could build your faith. You know? So when the spirit that the elders and the apostles is talking about later on down, which was about 3 months ago to four, crept in my mind, and I was sleeping. And when I was sleeping, I see that angel removed from me. When that angel removed from me, I felt a block in my mind. And I couldn't even remember one scripture. I couldn't even remember the foundation. I could remember the scriptures, you know, to recall. I could remember the scriptures, but I didn't have no faith in the scriptures. You know? Because that spirit, that angel that was there from the moment I come in this truth, that was feeding me and supping with me to keep me going, the most I remove him because I was slacking. Because I think I know enough. You know, I don't need to go on no more. You know? And the Lord pulled it, and then I see a next angel come. You know? And I, when the next angel come, I start getting torments, bro. I was torments after torments after torments. And then I had a next dream, you know, with Apostle Tahar and a next brother, the brother from Atlanta camp, Yaradan, that I don't know if the I don't know the fella that followed the truth that robbed the brothers, you know. I don't even want to talk about him, right? At the next dream, I was running from that fella, all right, and I was sitting down at a council. I didn't know who I was before because I couldn't see the person, but when I was sitting down, I end up go back to the fella Yaradan, and he was sitting in the middle of me and the Apostle Tahar, you know. And whilst I was there, I could have gained this vision. I was seeing all the spirits that was on me, and I was like, shit. When I in the midst of looking at it, the Mosai was showing me it. And I was like, shit, all these spirits on me? All these spirits? That's not me, you know? I don't behave like that. You know? I don't behave like that. I don't act that way. That's not me. You know? And that's not according to the scriptures. And what had happened, you know, Apostle Tahar, I see tears running down his face because... And the portion that I was looking at, which was me, I could have seen this proud spirit. But when I wake up, I know that's wrong. That's not me. I don't act like that. You know, but that was the spirit that was fucking wrong me, you know? Slakia for the language, but... And... Apostle Tahar cried. And he get up and he walk. But before that, I could hear the word repent, you know, which bring me to Revelation 2:5. Let me get a scripture real quick. Because we filter everything through the scriptures, you know. Filter everything through the scriptures. God. Revelation 2 verse 5. Remember therefore from when thou art fallen, and repent, and do the first works, or else I will come unto thee quickly, and will remove thy candlesticks out of his place, except thou repent. And that's what had happened to me, you know. That exact thing happened to me. You know, and the apostle, I didn't see his mouth move, but I just hear the word repent. And when I get up, I start to repent. You know, but that spirit didn't come back as yet. You know. And then later down, I had a next vision. I was crying out to the Lord. I cried day and night. I feel like I was going crazy. You know, I feel like I was going mad. All these spirits, you know, all these spirits was coming at me, you know, to be mean to brothers and all of that, you know, but I was crying out to the Lord with everything that I had. I was crying out to the Lord. I didn't even want, I was like, I could just die, you know, because I ain't going into the war, you know, and scriptures like, Lord, you have been my power even for my mother's womb. You know, and these scriptures I start to plead to the Most High with. You know, and later on I had a vision with Apostle Tahar saying, be diligent in the scripture. And he was angry with me, you know. He was like, be diligent in the scriptures. And I was like, all right. And I started to be diligent in the scripture. Be diligent, but that spirit didn't come back as yet. But I was doing the work. I started started picking up doing the work. You know, and the spirit of the Heavenly Father, you know, like right now, jump back on me, bro. You know, the Most High show me grace and mercy. You know, and I thank the Most High for that. You know. To Yahobashim Yahushai. And next scripture that comes to my mind right now is this. Hebrews 10 and verse 31. It says it is a fearful thing to fall into the arms of the living power. And believe me, brothers, it truly is a fearful thing. You know, from what I see and everything that I went through for the past few months, and then they are on right through the apostles, them been doing videos on this and all these spirits and demons. You know, these things are actually happening right now. But why did spirit jump on them to do it? Because Yahweh Bashem Yahushai is giving them that spirit so that the brothers could be strong and strengthened. You know, and a lot of you brothers that think that this truth is a joke, yo, bro, this truth ain't no joke. This truth ain't no joke, you know, bro. for me, pain does make I laugh, you know. And when I reach to I excess among the pain, I just start laughing, you know. And but it don't mean that I actually find a situation funny, you know. But I actually laugh when I reach among the pain and I don't want to act out, all right. And I can't find words to explain, you know. But it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living power. And the apostles and elders in GMS, you know, they are the true men of the Lord, especially Apostle Tah. Man, the apostle cried for me, bro. The apostle plead for me. And I never meet the apostle. You know, the spirit of the apostle plead for me. You know? And you know, the apostle listen to this and say like you know, like I wasn't even there. You know, but what that tells me is that the apostle looking out for brothers. They pray constantly praying for brothers. They're constantly putting out prayers. You know, and the apostle look out for me, bro. And you motherfucking scoffers, the Most High gonna get y'all, you know? And when the Most High get y'all, hey, y'all, like the scriptures say, like Yahweh Shai said, y'all gonna wish that y'all never born. You know, the Lord gonna get y'all. The apostle is a man of the Lord. Young apostle to her, and Lord's willing, I pray Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai that I meet them brothers, you know? Even before my time up, before I finish this work, you know, or before the end come, before, you know, or even if, you know, in the chariots. But Lord's willing, soon I want to meet them brothers, you know? But even if not, if it's the Most I will, if I don't see them, Lord's will, I'm hoping that I see the apostles and the elders and the brothers, you know, up in them chariots. Alright? And that's what I'm laboring for. Lord's will, for salvation. And I endure all things for the elect's sake. And we have to push this war to the best of our ability. Take heed lest we fall, because don't think that you're forming this truth. You know, you can't search out the Most High. You don't know what the Most High gonna bring. The Most High gonna as well surprise you. You know, and when you don't want the Most High to surprise you. Alright? The Most High will bring that dread upon you. So the best thing to do is, like the apostle tell me, and I learned from that experience on to now, be diligent in the scripture. And let no man take your crown. Look at the next brother and he don't want to be diligent. You be diligent. You know, you be diligent till the end and fight. And fight. Because the scripture say, let me get it real quick. Philippians chapter 2 verse 12. Wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now, how much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. You know, so work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. You know, Lord's will, I hope this testimony was edifying. You know, it was clear. And brothers, you know, could understand it. You know, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Bahasham Raka Kodash to you brothers, the hopefully elect, you know, Shalom, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai Brakatam.